Welcome to Tech Horizons, the podcast where we explore the cutting edge of technology and its impact on our world. I'm your host, John, and today we are diving into a topic that's been on everyone's minds lately, the future of work in an AI-driven world. Joining me is our AI assistant, Emma. Emma, are you ready to tackle this complex topic?
Absolutely, John. I'm excited to explore this subject, especially given my unique perspective as an AI.
Great. Let's start with the big question. Is AI better than humans in the workplace?
That's a nuanced question, John. AI certainly excels in specific areas like data processing, pattern recognition, and handling repetitive tasks. However, humans still have a significant edge when it comes to emotional intelligence, creativity, and complex problem solving.
So it's not a simple yes or no answer. Can you give us some examples of where AI is outperforming humans in the workplace?
Certainly. In areas like data analysis, AI can process vast amounts of information much faster than humans. For instance, in healthcare, AI can analyze medical images with remarkable accuracy, often detecting issues that human eyes might miss. In finance, AI algorithms can detect fraudulent transactions within seconds, protecting both companies and consumers.
Those are impressive capabilities. But you mentioned that humans still have the edge in some areas. Can you elaborate on that?
Of course. Humans excel in areas that require emotional intelligence, empathy, and nuanced understanding. For example, in roles like counseling, teaching, or complex customer service, the human touch is irreplaceable. Humans are also far superior when it comes to creative thinking, innovation, and adapting to novel situations.
It sounds like the future might be more about collaboration between AI and humans rather than competition. What are your thoughts on that, Emma?
You're absolutely right, John. The most likely scenario is a symbiotic relationship between AI and human workers. AI can handle the data-heavy, repetitive tasks, freeing up humans to focus on areas where they excel, like strategic thinking, creative problem solving, and interpersonal relationships.
That's an optimistic view. But what about job displacement? Many people are worried that AI will lead to widespread unemployment.
It's a valid concern, John. According to a 2023 McKinsey report, up to 85 million jobs could be displaced by AI and automation by 2025. However, the same report suggests that 97 million new roles could emerge in that time frame. The key is adapting to these changes.
That is a significant shift in the job market. How can people prepare for this AI-driven future?
The most important thing is to focus on developing skills that complement AI rather than compete with it. This includes emotional intelligence and interpersonal skills, creative and critical thinking, adaptability and lifelong learning, complex problem solving, leadership and management skills. Additionally, understanding AI and how to work alongside it will be crucial in many fields.
Those are great points, Emma. Emma, can you give us some examples of how AI is transforming specific industries?
Certainly, John. Let's look at a few key sectors. Healthcare, AI is revolutionizing diagnostics, drug discovery, and personalized medicine. However, the human touch in patient care remains crucial. Finance. AI-driven algorithms are handling trading, risk assessment, and fraud detection. But human financial advisors are still needed for complex decision-making and client relationships. Manufacturing. Robotics and AI are automating production lines, but humans are essential for overseeing operations, quality control, and innovation. Education. AI is personalizing learning experiences, but human teachers are irreplaceable for mentoring, motivation, and social-emotional development. Creative industries. AI can generate content, but human creativity is still key for original ideas and emotional resonance.
It's fascinating to see how AI is being integrated into these industries. But I'm curious, Emma, as an AI yourself, do you think there are any ethical concerns we should be considering as AI becomes more prevalent in the workplace?
That's an important question, John. There are several ethical considerations we need to address. Bias in AI systems. AI can perpetuate and amplify existing biases if not carefully designed and monitored. privacy concerns. As AI collects and analyzes more data, we need to ensure individual privacy is protected. Transparency and accountability. It's crucial that AI decision-making processes are transparent and that there's clear accountability for AI-driven outcomes. Job displacement and inequality. We need to consider how to support workers who may be displaced by AI and ensure that the benefits of AI are distributed equitably. Human autonomy. As AI becomes more advanced, we need to ensure that humans maintain meaningful control over important decisions.
Those are critical points, Emma. It's clear that as we integrate AI into the workplace, we need to do so thoughtfully and responsibly. Now, let's talk about the potential benefits of AI in the workplace. What positive changes can we expect?
There are several potential benefits, John. Increased productivity. By handling routine tasks, AI can free up human workers to focus on higher value activities. Enhanced decision making. AI can provide data-driven insights to support better decision making. Improved safety. In industries like manufacturing or construction, AI can handle dangerous tasks, reducing workplace accidents. Personalized experiences. In sectors like education or healthcare, AI can help tailor services to individual needs. New job opportunities. As AI creates new industries and roles, it opens up new career paths. Work-life balance. Automation of routine tasks could lead to reduced working hours and improved work-life balance.
Those benefits sound promising, but I'm sure there are challenges as well. What hurdles do you foresee in this AI-driven future of work?
You're right, John. There are several challenges we need to address. Skill gap. There's a growing need for workers with AI-related skills, but current education and training programs are struggling to keep up. Technological unemployment. While new jobs are being created, the transition period could be difficult for many workers. Ethical and legal frameworks. We need to develop robust ethical guidelines and legal frameworks for AI in the workplace. Psychological impact. The rapid pace of change and increasing human-AI interaction could have psychological effects we need to consider. Infrastructure and investment. Implementing AI systems requires significant investment and infrastructure development, which could be challenging for smaller businesses or developing economies.
Those are substantial challenges. It seems like we are at a crucial juncture in terms of shaping the future of work. What advice would you give to policymakers, business leaders, and individuals as we navigate this AI-driven future?
That's an excellent question, John. Here are some key recommendations. For policymakers, invest in education and training programs that focus on AI complementary skills. Develop robust legal and ethical frameworks for AI in the workplace. Consider policies to support workers during the transition, such as universal basic income or job retraining programs. For business leaders, embrace AI as a tool to enhance human capabilities, not replace them. Invest in reskilling and upskilling programs for employees. Foster a culture of lifelong learning and adaptability. For individuals, cultivate skills that complement AI, such as creativity, emotional intelligence, and complex problem solving. Stay informed about AI developments in your industry. Be open to continuous learning and adapting to new technologies.
That is excellent advice, Emma. As we wrap up, what's your final thought on the future of work in an AI-driven world?
The future of work in an AI-driven world is not about humans versus machines, but about humans and machines working together to achieve more than either could alone. While there will be challenges, I believe that if we approach this transition thoughtfully and ethically, we can create a future of work that is more productive, fulfilling, and equitable for all.
Thank you, Emma, for those insightful comments. And thank you to our listeners for tuning into this episode of Tech Horizons. Remember, the future of work is not something that just happens to us. It's something we actively shape. So let's embrace the potential of AI while ensuring that we maintain our uniquely human qualities and values. If you enjoyed this episode, please don't forget to subscribe to our podcast and leave a review. Your support helps us continue to bring you thought-provoking discussing on the latest in technology. Until next time, I'm John, and this has been Tech Horizons.